Hi everyone, it's me, Atom. That's spelled A-T-O-M, like the tiniest building blocks in the universe. Welcome to my lab, where steam is our paint, experiments are our brushes, and the world is our canvas. Whoa, look at this paint. It is so red. Well, what does that mean? What makes red, red? And that makes me wonder, if we were to mix colors together, do you think that we might can get different colors of paint? Let's find out. Have you ever wondered why we see colors? It all has to do with light. Did you know that white light, like what comes from the sun, is made up of different colors? You did? You're so smart. There are seven colors that make up white light. They're the same colors that you can find in a rainbow. Say, would you like to say the colors that make up rainbows and white light with me? Okay, here we go. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Great job! Thank you for saying the colors of the rainbow with me. Did you know that there is an easy way to remember the colors of a rainbow with one silly word? Yeah! Do you want to say it with me? Here we go! ROYGBIV! Isn't that a funny word to say? Hey, I know a song about ROYGBIV. Sing along with me! There's a silly word that's fun to say. It helps us learn the rainbow way. Just seven letters, let's give it a try. ROYGBIV, oh my! Red and orange and yellow, green and blue. Indigo and violet too. Red and orange and yellow, green and blue. Indigo and violet too. After the rain, look up so high. A rainbow stretches across the sky. Colors shine so big and bright. Let's name them now, let's get it right. Red and orange and yellow, green and blue. Indigo and violet too. Red and orange and yellow, green and blue. Indigo and violet too. ROYGBIV, it's fun to say. It helps us learn in a colorful way. Mix and match, there's so much to do. The world is full of every hue. Red and orange and yellow, green and blue. Indigo and violet too. Sing it loud, now you know that's the rainbow way to go. So next time you see a rainbow bright, remember ROYGBIV, say it right. You did a wonderful job singing the ROYGBIV song with me. When light shines on something, some of that light and some of the colors gets soaked up or absorbed, and some of it bounces back into our eyes. Wait, what? Did you know that a red apple is actually every color except red? It absorbs all of the other colors of light and bounces back only the red color to our eyes. That means a red apple is actually every color except red. Pretty cool, right? And it's the same for all the other colors too. A blue object absorbs all of the colors except blue, and a green object absorbs every color except green. But to keep things simple, we just say that something is colored the color that we see. Okay, now that we know what makes colors look the way they do, let's learn about the special colors that helps us make all of the other colors. These three colors are special colors because they're primary colors. But what does that word mean? Primary means first. These colors come first because they can't be made by mixing other colors together. They're like the starting colors in a big box of crayons. Think of it like baking cookies. If you don't have the first ingredients, like flour and sugar, you can't make cookies. And if you don't have red, blue, and yellow, you can't make the other colors. But these colors, these are called secondary colors, and that's because they come second. We make them by mixing two primary colors together, but we'll do that in just a bit. colors aren't just something we see, they can make us feel things too. Let's think about our three primary colors and how they make us feel. Red is bright and bold, like fire trucks and apples. How do you think red makes us feel? Red can make us feel excited, strong, or even a little brave. But sometimes red can also mean danger, like a stop sign. Blue is cool and calm, like the sky and the ocean. How do you think blue makes us feel? Blue can make us feel peaceful, relaxed, or even a little sleepy. That's the reason why some people like to paint their bedrooms blue. Yellow is happy and warm, like the sun and bananas. How do you think yellow makes us feel? Yellow can make us feel cheerful, excited, and full of energy. It's like a big bright smile. Would you like to help me make the secondary colors by mixing together two primary colors? Great! Let's make a hypothesis. A hypothesis is a smart guess about what you think will happen when you do something. Here's how you make one. First, look and think. What are we trying to figure out? For example, if I put a toy boat in the bathtub, what will happen? Second, make a smart guess. Think about what you already know. For example, I think the boat will float because I have seen other boats float on water. Third, test your guess. Try it out. Put the boat in the water and see what happens. Fourth, see if you were right. Did your guess happen? Yes or no? If not, that's okay. It's okay to make mistakes. Scientists learn from testing different ideas. A simple hypothesis sentence can be, if I put my toy boat in the water, then the boat will float. That's it. A hypothesis is a smart guess you can test. Are you ready to make a hypothesis with me? Let's look and think. What are we trying to figure out? That's right. We're trying to figure out what will happen when we mix together two primary colors. What do you think will happen if we mix these colors together? What new colors do you think we can get when we mix these two colors together? Time to make a smart guess. Let's start with what we already know. We know that white light is made up of many different colors. We know that all the colors that are in white light are the same colors that are in a rainbow. We also know that red, blue, and yellow are all in a rainbow also. Maybe if we mix these primary colors together, the secondary colors will be all the other colors that are in a rainbow. What color do you think we can make when we mix red and blue paint together? That's a great guess. I'm going to guess that it also makes purple. So let's make the hypothesis. If I mix red and blue paint together, then it will turn purple. Now, what color do you think we can get if we mix together blue and yellow paint? Ooh, that's an interesting guess. I'm going to guess that blue and yellow, when mixed together, will make the color orange. So my hypothesis is, when I mix blue and yellow paint together, it will turn orange. Do you think that's the right guess? You don't? Well, we'll see what happens when we do our experiment. That's why we do experiments, to help us find out if we were right or wrong when we made our hypothesis. Finally, what color do you think we'll get when we mix together the colors red and yellow? You think that we'll get the color orange for this one? Okay, I'll go with your guess on this one. I will also say, if I mix together red and yellow paint, then we will get orange. Now that we're done making our smart guesses, our hypothesis, let's test them out to see if we were right or wrong. Here we go. I hypothesize that we will get the color purple when we mix blue and red together. Let's see what will happen. Uh-oh. I think we're going to need to add a little bit more red. Ooh. We gotta get all the red in, but it's starting to change. Look at that. It makes the color purple. So red plus blue equals purple. Isn't that cool? Look at that. Red and blue equals purple. So that means that red and blue paint, when mixed together, will make purple, like grapes and plums. On this one, I hypothesize that when we mix together blue and yellow paint, then we will get orange. Let's see if I'm right. Uh-oh, it's starting to turn. Well, that doesn't look very orange now, does it? Uh-oh, I was wrong. Oops, my guess was wrong. When blue and yellow paint are mixed together, we get green, like grass and frogs. But that's okay, because we learned something new today. Scientists make mistakes all the time, and guess what? That's how they learn new things. Mistakes help our brains grow. That's why scientists test out their ideas. Let's move on. Now it's time to test out red plus yellow. Look at that. So that means red plus yellow equals orange, like pumpkins and oranges. Now I know the right colors to mix together to get the secondary colors, and I won't forget. The best way to learn is by trying and testing. Oops means I'm learning. Look, we were right. Mixing together the primary colors to get the secondary colors helped us get more colors that are found in a rainbow. Hey, I got a great idea. Let's count them to make sure that we got them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, that's not right now, is it? We only have 6 colors here, but there are 7 colors that are found in a rainbow. Hey, let's see what colors we have to figure out which one is missing. Are you ready? Here we go. Red, blue, yellow, orange, green, purple, or we could say violet. Which one do you think is missing? You're right. We're missing indigo. How do you think we'll get indigo? Let's start with what we already know. Indigo is the color that is found between blue and violet, or purple in a rainbow. Do you think that we can get the color indigo if we mix blue and purple together? Let's make a smart guess or a hypothesis. If I mix blue and purple paint together, we'll get indigo. Now, let's test our hypothesis. I'll get out my purple paintbrush, clean it off a little bit. And now I'm going to get a little bit of blue paint here. Ooh, look at that. That's a really pretty blue purple color. Look at that bluish purple color. We call that indigo. So blue plus purple equals indigo. We were right. Great job. We know that red, blue, and yellow makes us feel different things. But what about the new colors that we made? Let's think. Purple is a mix of red and blue. Red is exciting and blue is calm. So how do you think purple makes us feel? Purple can feel mysterious and magical. It's the color of royalty, fancy things, and deep space. Now, green is made of blue and yellow. Blue is peaceful and yellow is happy. How do you think green makes us feel? Green makes us feel fresh and full of life. It reminds us of nature, trees, and growing things. And orange is a mix of red and yellow. Red is strong and yellow is bright. How do you think orange makes us feel? Orange feels warm and full of energy. It's the color of sunsets, autumn leaves, and fun things like basketballs and oranges. Let's not forget about indigo. It's a mix of blue and purple. Blue is calm and purple is mysterious and magical. How do you think indigo makes us feel? Indigo is a deep, mysterious color. It's like the sky when it's about to turn completely dark. It makes you feel calm, like when you're looking up at the night sky and you see all the pretty stars. It's also a little magical, like something secret is hiding in the universe, just waiting to be discovered. What does indigo make you think of? Maybe a wizard's robe, a deep ocean, or a dreamy nighttime adventure? Now, would you like to play a remembering game with me? Great! I'll show you two primary colors and you tell me what color they mix together to create. First up, blue plus yellow. What color do you think we can get when we add blue to yellow? Right, blue plus yellow equals green. Now, what color do you think we can get when we add red to blue? Right, red plus blue equals purple. Last one, what color do you think we can get when we add red to yellow? Great job! Red plus yellow equals orange. Red and blue make purple see. Blue and yellow make green for me. Red and yellow make orange so bright. Mixing colors is fun. All right! Colors are everywhere, look and see. What colors can you find with me? What colors can you find? Look around you and call out the colors that you see. Are there any colors that mix to make new ones? Wonderful job! You did an amazing job learning all about colors today. Keep exploring colors all around you, and I'll see you next time for more fun at Adam's Lab. Bye-bye!